Sharpness. A Sunday afternoon and many people come to see the tankers leave the port and into the River Severn. Many are bound for Swansea to load another cargo of oil. Inbound can be seen a loaded shell tanker, about to swing 180 degrees to stem the incoming tide before slowly entering the dock outer basin. From the deck of one of the Swansea-bound tankers, we look across to view the newly opened nuclear power station near to Berkeley. Hard to imagine that, after 30 years' service, the two large reactors are encased in concrete, whilst the office buildings are now home to a college of further education. Soon we pass the construction of the Severn Suspension Bridge, passing beneath work on spinning the cables on which the bridge decking will hang from. One of the Oster Beachley ferries is seen approaching the Beachley slipway. Soon after the bridge was opened in 1966, the ferries ceased trading. Yet the slipway remains in use today, for this is the site of SARA, lifeboats of the Severn Area Rescue Association. Thank you. now in the Bristol Channel, passing the two islands of Flatholm and Steepholm. Passing us at speed is one of Campbell's White Funnel fleet of paddle steamers. Soon we passed Barry Island, not really an island, but the name given to this popular seaside destination with its pleasure park, Butlin's holiday camp and other typical amusements. Travel aboard the Grovedale H, one of Harker's larger craft, a black oiler, built in 1967 at Nottingley. Some of the Dale boats are slow, and here we are seen passing the Weasdale H, built in 1960. She had an 8-cylinder air-cooled Paxman engine, with a top speed of 8 knots. This compares to the Grovedale H, top speed of 10 knots. Change vessels to travel aboard the BP Miller, one of the seven shell boats on contract to John Harker Ltd. Travelling empty in a choppy sea was an experience. Many a new deckhand only travelled the one way, then travelled back home from Swansea by train. Going through the Nash, as it was known, was not for the faint-hearted, with high cliffs on one side, having a lighthouse to guide you by, and extensive sandbanks on the other, it left just a narrow channel to navigate through. Harker's lost two vessels on the rocks at the base of the cliff, the Widow H in 1959 and the BP Driver in 1962, fortunately with no loss of life. Thank you. As the vessels passed the Kenfig buoy off Bridge End and Port Talbot, there was a terrific swell which caused the tankers to roll, even on a good day. In Swansea Bay, we see a variety of vessels in and out of the port, including a submarine. Once safely locked up into Swansea Docks, the tankers would proceed to the far end of the Queen's Dock to berth, ready to receive the cargo of oil. Thank you. One of the vessels I worked on, the Winsdale H, can be seen bunkering a Turkish ship in Swansea Docks. Shell Traveller leaves Swansea Lock loaded to go out into Swansea Bay to anchor, to wait for the flood tide to assist them back up the Bristol Channel. The next and final film in this series will be coming soon, showing Harkers at work in the Bristol Channel and in the River Parret at Dumball near Bridgewater. If you have enjoyed my film, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel.